Welcome to the 2023 installment of 32 and 32 season previews. I'm Dan Rosen, along with Amelie Benjamin, and we're going to touch on everything from off-season moves and playoff outlook to fantasy prep with Anna Dua a little later. And today we're taking a look at everything Florida Panthers, a team you, Amelie, got very familiar with last year with a run to the Stanley Cup Final that came out of nowhere. Nobody saw it coming. They barely sneak into the playoffs. You start covering them, and you don't stop.
I think I have a new residence in South Florida after 2 months of being there watching this run. There's a little heat, a little humidity, and really good hockey. But this team going into 2023-24 is going to pay a price for that Stanley Cup run. I don't think they'd trade it, but you have injuries to Matthew Tkachuk, Brandon Montour, Aaron Ekblad, all of which are going to impact the upcoming season with those players out for training camp and potentially into the season. You add that to the exhaustion that comes with a Stanley Cup final run, and where do the Florida Panthers start the season?
Right. That's definitely the biggest storyline for them going into this, this season, into training camp, the guys, the exhaustion like you talked about. And I think some of the moves that they made this offseason is an attempt to counter some of that, right? So they add on defense. They add Oliver Ekman-Larsson. They add Nico Mikkola. They add Dmitry Kulikov. Guys that can fill roles for them. There's no question about it. Evan Rodriguez up front. Evan Rodriguez is a very versatile player. I think he's going to fill a lot of different holes for the Florida Panthers. They added Anthony Stolarz in net, too. Just adding to their goaltending depth, although Sergei Bobrovsky did turn into the number one Sergei Bobrovsky. But, and there's always a but, right? They did lose Radko Gudas. Radko Gudas signed with Anaheim. They did lose Mark Stahl. He signed with Philadelphia. They traded Anthony Duclair. And in addition now with Tkachuk and Ekblad and Montour coming off their injuries and their uncertainty at the start of the season, the big question for the Florida Panthers is, are they going to pay that price? And how big of a price is it going to be? Because they saw last year how hard it is to get in. And if you start slow, it's nearly impossible. They almost did the impossible last year.
Well, see, that's where I'm going to play a little bit of devil's advocate, because they started slowly last year. Right. And they went through this. They were trying to adjust to new coach Paul Maurice. So they had not the start of the season that they had expected. And so they go in with that experience of being able to turn it on as the season wound down. So if they do have a rough start to the season with these guys out, with the exhaustion coming to this year, are they a team that actually knows how to turn a season around that's not going well? Maybe I'm just playing devil's advocate, but
I mean, that's really hard to do in this league, and we know that because there's dates that really tell us and statistics that tell us that if you're not in a certain position by this certain date, you can be in trouble. So they have to try to counter what we expect could be a slow start. But there's a fantasy element to all these teams, and the Florida Panthers have a lot of intriguing players. Anna, that's why we're going to bring you in here. What intrigues you about the Florida Panthers in terms of fantasy?
The storyline I'm tracking has got to be Sergei Bobrovsky after the postseason he just had. He was my MVP running up straight till the Stanley Cup final. He was 12-6 in the postseason, 915 save percentage, just some phenomenal hockey. And he's been having some regular season woes as of late, but two seasons ago he was tied with Andrei Vasilevsky for the most wins in the entire NHL. So he has that caliber in him. He's won Vezina trophies in the past, and if he can bring any of that momentum from this amazing playoff run he just went on into the regular season this year, he's got to be a top 10 fantasy goalie heading into the season.
Well, and I think the interesting thing, Anna, with Sergei Bobrovsky too, is you talk about the momentum. I think we're too hard on the guy sometimes, to be honest with you. And if he plays 80% of what he did in the playoffs last year, he's going to be a great fantasy goalie for you.
I agree, and he can play despite any circumstances. You mentioned some of the pieces that this Panthers squad lost, but look at what numbers he put up in Columbus. He has that ability. He just needed a little bit of confidence in Florida that I haven't seen him get, and he got that this postseason. So maybe this next regular season, Sergei Bobrovsky is right back up there where we're used to seeing him.
All right, so we're doing playoff predictions. We're going to bring you in. We're going to leave you here for that. Your playoff prediction for the Florida Panthers.
This division just has gotten so much tougher this season. A team's going to drop out, and I think Florida's right on the cusp. I think they're going to be in the competition. It's going to be a neck-to-neck wild card race, but I have Florida not making it this season.
Not making it. All right. Emily?
I think very similar. I think it's going to be the same situation that they were in last season, that they are right there at the end, that it's going to come down to the last couple games. I think they have a team that could make it, But Anna is right. There's too much talent, too many teams up and coming. Buffalo, you're looking at. Pittsburgh, you're looking at maybe a comeback into the playoffs this year. I think they're just going to miss it by just that little bit.
Buffalo's the team that I look at as a team that's really on the rise. And I think the Sabres do get in. And Pittsburgh's another one that you mentioned. It's a good one, too. So I'm in agreement with you guys. I think the Florida Panthers, they'll be a solid team. They'll be in the mix. But these injuries at the start, I think it's going to be a slow start for them. And you can't do it twice in a row. So I do not have the Florida Panthers in the playoffs. Thanks for joining us. And a reminder that NHL.com is providing in-depth roster, prospect, and fantasy analysis for each of the league's 32 teams every single day from August 1st through September 1st. And of course, you can find us right here on NHL.com and NHL YouTube as we continue to break it all down. We'll see you next time on 32 and 32.